Hi, welcome. Today we are going to study Lipinski's rule of fives. When we want to study Lipinski's rule, initially we should know what is bioavailability. The activity of a drug is related to its bioavailability. Bioavailability is defined as the fraction of the dose of a drug that is found in general circulation. So it means that when we take any drug in any form, what the fraction of that drug which is found in general circulation, that fraction is called as bioavailability. Now consequently, for a compound to be suitable as a lead, it must be bioavailable. In order to assess a compound's bioavailability, it must be either available off the shelf or be synthesized. Synthesis of a compound could result in the synthesis of an inactive compound, which could be expensive both in time and money. It means that when we synthesize any compound which acts as a drug, at that time there is a formation of that compound as well as inactive compound may be formed. It means that there is a formation of mixture, and from that mixture we have to separate inactive compound. So it is expensive both in time and money, because we are going to separate that active compound and inactive compounds. So in order to avoid unnecessary work and expense in synthesizing inactive molecules, Lipinski et al. Proposed a set of four rules that would predict whether a molecule was likely to be orally bioavailable. So Lipinski et al. Proposed a set of four rules. These rules may be summarized as having, so Lipinski's rule of fives: if we synthesize any compound, or we want to synthesize any compound which can act as a drug, that compound should have a molecular mass less than 500. This is the first rule. Then second one is hydrogen bond acceptor groups should be less than 10. Hydrogen bond acceptor groups, for example, oxygen, nitrogen, etc. Then third rule, hydrogen bond donor groups should be less than 5. For example, NH and OH group, etc. And last rule is a calculated value of log of P should be less than 5, where P is the calculated partition coefficient for the octanol water system. So this is the set of four rules which is called as Lipinski's rule of fives. Now any compound that fails to comply with two or more of the rules is unlikely to be bioavailable, that is, it is unlikely to be active. Lipinski's rules are based on multiples of 5. See, when we consider any rule of these four, all these are multiples of 5. 500 is a multiple of 5, 10 is multiple of 5, this is 5 and this is also 5. So Lipinski's rules are based on multiples of 5 and so are often referred to as the rule of 5. So it is a set of four rules which is called as rule of fives. Why fives? Because it is based on multiples of 5. Now for example, see, simple example, aspirin. When we consider structure of aspirin, the molecular weight is 180 Dalton. It is less than 500 according to first rule of Lipinski. Then hydrogen bond acceptor groups are 4. See here, 1 oxygen, 2nd oxygen, 3rd oxygen and 4th oxygen. So hydrogen bond acceptor groups are 4, which are less than 10. Then hydrogen bond donor groups, there is only one hydrogen bond donor group, that is OH, again, which is less than 5, and the calculated value of log of p, it is 2.4, and it is again less than 5. So this aspirin molecule obeys the all 4 rules of Lipinski. Therefore, that aspirin is orally bioavailable. Now, other researchers have developed similar methods to assess the bioavailability of molecules prior to synthesis. However, it should be realized that Lipinski's and other similar rules are only guidelines. So, this is all about the Lipinski's rule of 5s. Thank you.